so honored to have Professor Edward Antina here to meet Antina Machado. Professor Antina is a professor at the Liceo Conservatory in Barcelona and director of the Escola de Música de Barcelona. So welcome, Professor Antina.
Thank you.
Let's start off with our first question. So could you share some of your personal story and how you grew up as a musician with us?
Well, I grew up among the music because my parents were musicians. My father was a violinist and my mother played piano very well. So for me, it was very easy to start playing piano, of course. And that happened many years ago and I still play piano. So the whole life has been involved in piano. A lot, and I try to grow up in that sense. So it gave me a lot of confidence. That's what I mean. So competitions are very hard, but I think they give you a lot of confidence.
Right, that's true. Professor
Edward,
could you share some you play so many concerts every year. How do you maintain your repertoire? How do you practice, like in general?
I don't practice so much. I have practiced a lot years ago. I think now my repertoire is okay, and I try to maintain it like it should be. So. For concert. But I think I don't have many problems.
I know that you have been running the Escola de Música de Barcelona for many years. You must be having a lot of memorable moments. Could you share some of it with us?
Yes, you know, I think the most interesting aspect of running a music school is how you can follow the evolution of your little pianists and you follow them along their whole career. So they start, they play very, very little things, but as years pass, you see they grow up themselves, but their possibilities also with them. And this is a very beautiful aspect of running a music school.
Thank you so much for sharing with me. And I actually have another question, which is, how is the musical environment in Barcelona?
It's quite good environment. We have two big concert halls. One is quite modern, the other one not so much, but they are very different. They are huge and they are very beautiful. And we have two orchestras, and all the great musicians come to Barcelona. It's yes, a very interesting musical life.
Professor Antina, I know that you are an expert of playing Venice music, and you are also a of Avenue's level. How can any pianist play better in Avenue's or Granada's music?
You know, in 21st century, there are so many possibilities through internet to listen and to see how certain Spanish pianists play our music, that you get all the necessary information. Years ago it was much more difficult because you didn't have those possibilities. For example, I remember I have seen that Arthur Rubinstein, when he wanted to play Spanish music, he played a lot of Manuel de Falla, Lenin, he played many of those pieces. Well, first of all, he went to Spain, to south of Spain, and he stayed there several months. Just to know how was the people there, how was the music there. And this helped him a lot for his interpretations.
Yes.
And he was very good playing Spanish music, no. He didn't play many Spanish music, but several pieces by Anita Lamentafaya. But other great pianists also did the same. So if you know how is the country of a country, you can make a better approach to the music. It's the same if you play Chopin and go to Poland.
Yeah.
You have more possibilities to play Polanka as it should be.
Yeah.
So it's the same.
So also we need to learn the dance, the triangle.
Yes. Yes, of course. Because flamenco has a lot of things in common with our composers. You know, I think it's important nowadays that besides the normal repertoire they play, which is generally classical, I think it's necessary that they look also at 20th century and even 21st century. So they have to have a better contact with the music which is written nowadays. Not only the music which was written 3 centuries ago.
Really? I see. So, like modern
pieces,
do you mean?
Yes.
Yes.
I think it's important. It's very important that they can play something of their century, of their yes.
When you learn classical music, you're learning Mozart,
yeah.
Chopin.
Yeah, Beethoven, Brahms, Schumann, and sometimes you play something by Ravel.
Yeah.
Well, that's enough. Well, think about the others,
right,
which are close to our days.
I see. Thank you so much for sharing with us.
Ligeti, for example.
Ligeti.
For example.
Right.
Yes.
Thank you so much, Professor, for your interview with us.
Great pleasure.
Thank you.
Thanks. Thank you.